Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude.
You have been warned.
Huh?
Hey guys, girls, James here, aka Wade McGinnis, and today on the good, the bad, the OMG, Snake Pass. Now you get this on PC, Switch, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One for $19.99 or your regional equivalent. It is from Sumo Digital. Let's see how this indie platformer did. The story starts with a strange creature knocking down all the crystals in the area. These allow teleportation between the many floating lands. Of course, the job of finding and collecting these fall onto Noodle the Snake and his hyperactive buddy Doodle the Hummingbird. To be honest, there really is not that much in the way of story or character. This is a very basic reason for why the characters are out and about. Even the end isn't anything to write home about. It's sad because I remember having fond memories of games with great story and platforming, like Jak and Daxter. As I went through the game hoping for some new development or ability, you get nothing? At the end of the game, you realize why the crystals were being knocked down, and it's just as underwhelming. It's a missed opportunity to give the player a reason to care for these characters. The core gameplay loop will have you moving around trying to collect blue globs, golden coins, and the three crystals to open a portal to the next area. Well, try not to die. This is something that could and probably be one of the sticking points of the game, the checkpoint system. There are stone tablets on the ground that mark your progress in the game. Should you die before reaching that, you will have to start from where you left off, meaning having to recollect all the items. Early on, this is not that bad, as each item you need or want to collect tends to be easy or have minor difficulty. But by the second zone, this starts to change. I found that if I interact with a wheel or a lever or crystal, that would transfer over, but the globs or coins would not. Meaning if you're a completionist, this game might frustrate you to no end. Make a mistake and you weren't able to reach a checkpoint? Do it all over again. Now, I have to say that I love the world and the design of the platforming puzzles. They are clever and allow for some room for gamers to solve it their way. Giving the controller to a friend, I found him solve it a different way than me. Something I hadn't thought of. He straight up bypassed the puzzle by using another puzzle to get to where he needed. Now, why collect any of these? Well, the golden coins, aka gatekeeper coins, and the blue globs give you a retro version of Noodle and Doodle. Of course, it's just fun to try and figure out how to solve the climbing puzzle to get to the item as well. Once you beat a level, you unlock a trial run of that level, so you can come back and speedrun. Now, I said earlier that there isn't really ability you get. There is and there isn't. You have to complete the entire thing, and it's snake vision. Allows you to see any missing collectible. So if you weren't sure where that one coin was, go back to that mission and use snake vision. Once you beat a level, you unlock a trial run of that level. There's a learning curve to this game that other platformers do not have. Wrapping your mind around how Noodle should move and traverse the world is hard. Once you get that understanding, the difficulty, it's still there. The game doesn't become any easier as the levels go on. Part of me loves this. I enjoy having a challenge. The level design for each zone and the variety of the zone with the new mechanics for Noodle to overcome is great. Having to figure out how to get to that shiny gold coin or crystal, these little physics-based puzzles will have you chewing on how best to get there. Of course, you can cheese certain things in the game, but overall, there is a real sense of accomplishment. I need to stop the video. The camera in this game is so bad that I died over 100 times in the last three levels. These levels are wind-based and require you to constantly move the camera to see where you're going. The problem is the camera does not like to follow the action, getting stuck on everything, obscuring your view, or slingshotting your camera to the other side, resulting in a death. I tried to switch the control scheme from default to easy, but that really doesn't help that much. The placement of the buttons without the option to remap them also screws you over. If I want it, by default control, to get across, I had to hold the right trigger to move, the A button to lift my head, the left trigger to grip while controlling the camera all at the same time. Had I been able to remap the lift head to the left or right bumper, it would have mitigated some of the issues I had with the game. Or just have a camera that works. That's a difficulty. The other part has me wondering how a younger gamer can play this game. It's odd because it looks like something the younger audience would love, but the difficulty is staggering. Almost as if the game is targeted at gamers who love the classic games, but want something to match their current skill. I might be wrong here, but that's the vibe I'm getting with this title. Snake Pass is what I envision a new Viva Pinata would look like. The graphic style and the bright colors feel like a Rare title. I keep coming back to Rare, but it's hard not to when they, in many ways, defined a genre and a visual aesthetic. Snake Pass is just as good with variety in different looks for the game. Seeing each blade of grass bend and move in the wind, the jungle and ruin themes having pronounced textures, the items you have to collect are obvious to the gamer, bright, colorful looking globs of blue or the golden coins. The water effects both above and below the surface really look amazing on PC and the Switch. The downside is I notice a few technical hiccups. There were a few times where I noticed a drop in frames on the PC version, roughly 60 down to 45 to 50 frames. Sporadic, and I couldn't seem to lock down why. The downside is the skybox and the landscape that is in the background isn't really up to snuff. They are painted on, which does a nice little aesthetic, but it's not enough to have them mesh well with the foreground, looking slightly off when you compare it to the rest of the title. Jumping into this game is like jumping into the soundscape of a Rare title. Little nods to past platformers, both visually and auditory, are littered all about the game, and I love it. The music has an uplifting and nostalgic touch to it, centered around a jungle thing that we really don't get as often as I'd like. Really, this music, title screen most of all, would easily fit into a Saturday morning kids show. It's great, doesn't overshadow anything, and just adds to the experience. Voice? Well, there really isn't any. It's the standard animal noises and grunts. But these grunts are adorable and have some character to them. Listening to Noodle freak out as he comes close to falling is an early warning sign to the gamer and something to chuckle at. I had a number of issues where the camera would stick on a surface or get trapped behind a surface. A few times where I told Noodle to raise his head, but the button prompt would not work, resulting in a few deaths. Snake Pass does a wonderful job of trying something new and unique. The idea of slithering around as a snake is fun. I would never think it would be as engaging and challenging as it is. But my issue is the camera, something that 3D platformers still struggle with today. It's not intuitive, loves to stick behind or in everything. Combine that with the inability to remap the controller, and you'll be raging mid to end game, coming up with unique swear words to match the unique playstyle, with a checkpoint system that looks to be a bit more punishing than it needs to be, making a unique title a buy or rental or wait for sale. If Sumo allowed for remapping of the controls, then I would say pick this up. However, until then, slide on by.